Hello and welcome back to Kona. Today we're playing part 3, and last time we discovered the doctor's office and found some evidence, and now we're back in the snow following some wolf footsteps or tracks, and we just warmed ourselves up here on the fire and found an empty bottle. I don't think there is anything more here. So let's continue following those tracks and see where they're going. Wait, did I just lose them? Where are they? Oh, here. Okay. Alright. Looks like we're on the street now. But I need to go and find... Oh, here they are. Okay. I need to follow those tracks because I don't know if they go along the street or not. It seems like they're pretty much... What's that? Oh, that's nothing. Okay. So, okay, they're crossing the street now. Okay. I can barely see those tracks. Especially not in this brush. Oh, God. Okay, oh, here they are. Alright. Okay, it seems like they're leading to this property here. I'm just gonna keep following them. It's like totally fenced in. Doesn't seem to be a way to get in here though. And the tracks stop. I guess I'm supposed to look at this.
Sometimes, and especially around here, people are so possessive with their land as a dog is with hydrants.
Okay, what's in here? Package and a note. Here's the spark plug you ordered for your Olympic ski-doo. Okay, some kind of spark plug that maybe we need later on or anything? No, I didn't want to use the camera. So how the heck do I get in here? Tracks kind of stop here. Oh, okay, got it. I gotta break the lock. God, I'm doing so many illegal things here. Breaking into people's houses, into their yards, into their cars. Lamothe's garage. Let's see what's in this car. Snowmobile skis, okay. And an empty bottle, again.
What good was a motorless car? The mechanic sure had an odd way to go about repairing things.
Maybe he needed this for another car. Another one of those ice dinghies. Let's take a picture for our collection. Even though they all look the same, but I'm just gonna do it. See if there's anything here on the side of the house. Doesn't look like there's anything interesting. Let's get in. Let's see what's going on here.
The man seemed petrified in ice. What Carl saw terrified him, and he didn't know if it was the fear or the cold that was responsible for his hair standing on end all over his body. The poor man, before being frozen solid, seemed to be defending the entrance to his cabin. But from what?
Wow, that's definitely creepy. I can hear my heartbeat.
The very first steps of man on the moon were made more than a year ago. The event had surely captivated the mechanic's mind for him to still keep this around.
Yeah, it looks like he lived here. Okay, there's a box with probably some goodies. No, nothing at all. What the hell? Gotta go find some good stuff here. Still need a wire. Alright, nothing. A whole bunch of nothing. Absolutely nothing. Are we missing something here? A headlight. Not so sure what I need that for, but we'll find out. I'm actually surprised I can collect more stuff. Handlebars. Alright. Alright, this is nothing. Oh, here we go. Another note.
The week of October 5th, thought Carl. That was this week. The plug should have been here by now.
Yeah, it is actually. It's in the mailbox. All right, let's get out of here. Leave this creepy scene and see what's going on in the main house. But first I want to see what's here. What is this? Another headlight? Seriously? What's here? There's nothing here.
Carl had a hunch that there had got to be a plan somewhere that could help him put this thing back together.
Oh, I see. I have to make this workable again. All right. We'll have to find this plan, I guess.
Nice carillon. They say it's supposed to soothe the soul. But with this powerful gale that seemingly never sleeps, it was far more likely to get on anyone's nerves.
What's that say? Hamilton, I won't be your dog anymore. Ooh, looks like someone was angry.
The milk was sorted by color, from the whitest to the greenest, or in other words, from the freshest to the sourest. Perhaps someone was expecting an important call. In any case, that person's in for a long wait. Carl already noticed that telephone services weren't provided in this area.
Oh, nice, getting warm again. What's that?
Roswell, Atamipec, same story. Large deserts conducive to extravagant follies.
Huh, looks like the police cannot support your claim about a man. Interesting. So he's seen something. What's this? Polaroid film. When one isn't enough, why not buy eight? Okay. Quarter. Parts manual. Oh, that's the one I'm supposed to read about how to build the snowmobile or fix it. Patched everything up at the tracks. I left them close by. Skate, don't drink and work, don't. Okay, well, I already know that. But thanks for the advice.
Weird stuff. Kind of a crossing between a colander and a hairdryer. What was it for? To play telepath? To protect against nuclear waves?
There's some pins on this map. Doesn't show what it is.
Carl deducted this was a map of the area. Were those pins pointing to places of interest?
Yeah, I should kind of take a note on those pins here. I'm not so sure if my map has those areas on it or not, but there is three pins around the lake for sure.
If some daring person could manage to get their hands on the missing parts, Carl was willing to bet that the craft would have taken flight.
Okay, a hammer. I guess I could use that to fix the snowmobile or to kill someone with it. I hope I don't have to do that. All right. Apparently Lamothe is a rock collector. I think I got it all. Can't really find anything else. Nope, check that too. Aha, fire starter, I'm glad I checked that. Can never have enough things to make a fire with, it's so cold. I use this. Mowing the lawn is unnecessary at this time. Ha! I love the sense of humor in this game. Okay, that was matches, I think. Oh, there's another trash can down here. make sure I check that. All right, we have some duct tape, always good to have. Just making sure I didn't leave anything and check everything. I think I checked this already, didn't I? Yeah. Okay. Oh, there is a gas pump. Fill up gas can. This is not working. How do I get this to work? Most likely need this for the snowmobile, but I don't know. I don't know how to turn it on, and I don't see really where does this go here. Ooh, I don't want to fall down there. What's in here? Oh, nothing.
By following the plan, Carl was led to believe that the snowmobile's parts had to be scattered about in the vicinity.
Alright, that looks about right. So what else can we put on this thing? Place track. That doesn't work. I didn't find the tracks. No. Wait, that's not what I meant to do. Place skis. Okay, skis are on. Place handlebars. Light and handlebars. Okay. So now it looks pretty much complete, but I don't have the track. I don't even know what the track looks like. I didn't find anything. I searched this whole place. Or at least I thought I did. So where does this go? Let's see. It seems like you're supposed to go up here for some reason. No, that's nothing. I don't really actually know what this thing is. I guess this guy built this so he has a good lookout here. But there's really nothing up here for me to find or use at this moment. That's too bad. What could the tracks be? I searched here everywhere. Oh, those are saws or saw blades. Okay, I need to find out how to get to this secret project place. It seems like I have to go up there and to the left. Yes.
Carl hadn't lived up to his good finder reputation. He still hadn't found any of the wealth contained in Lamothe's lands.
Oh, there's another icicle. Let's take a picture real quick. Okay, that's done. Kind of weird. I don't know if this is some kind of sign here. This wooden beam. Okay, let's follow those tracks. Really curious to find out what this secret place is. Can't go through here. Guess I have to go around somehow. Uh-oh. I should take a picture of this wolf before he runs away. I don't want to go closer just in case he's dangerous. It's a little far away. Oh well. Should I be concerned? I'm gonna go and take my... I don't want to shoot it. Let's take the crowbar. Maybe I can just scare it away. I really don't want to kill this wolf. If I don't have to. Maybe he's friendly. No. Oh god. I don't know if this crowbar is gonna make him go away. Oh god. Really don't want to have to kill you. No. I feel bad. But I guess I have to.
Carl never thought he would be dancing with the wolves.
Yeah, that's too bad that I had to kill him. But I had to save my life. And my health is down a little bit. So I'm hoping I'm getting to this place soon. Because I don't want to encounter more wolves. And we have another icicle to take a picture of. There you go. God, how many are there? And some kind of a grave.
The blood and the shape of the hole in the ground left no room for doubt. Someone had been buried here. Someone whose life had been taken with blunt force. Where was the body now? Why had it been buried, only to be dug up later? Carl felt as though he was shrouded in fog.
Okay, so we need to make another fire because I'm pretty cold and I also need to get my health up, so hopefully that comes up a little bit too. Yeah, looks like it. Okay, let's see. We're almost there. Just want to make sure I'm okay to walk further. Alright, we're good. Let's continue this trip. Hope I can open this. Break fence. Ah, there we go. Breaking things again. Breaking and entering. Oh well. Oh, what do we have here? A fire starter. Okay. Thank you for that. Wow, this is pretty. A pretty cool way here. I love that. Sure curious to see where this goes. Oh, there's a fork. I'm gonna go up here, I think. Just to see if there's something hidden over here that's some kind of a goodie or something I can use. Still looking for a wire, and I'm also looking for tracks for my snowmobile. Who knows what's over here?
That large antenna in the middle of the path. Undoubtedly ideal in attempting to communicate with little green men, was quite awkwardly placed. There had to be a lever to control it, maybe behind it. Carl would have to figure out how to reach it.
That's funny. I think I shouldn't have gone here first, but now it's done. An empty bag and a bicycle. What is a bicycle doing here? I guess someone got stranded over here because this way is not going any further. Kind of crashed, broke. So now I'm gonna go and see if I can get over there to that house. I'm not sure what that switch really did. I hope I didn't make a mistake by switching that switch on or off or whatever. Let's find out what this is all about over here, shall we?
The electric terminals appear to be linked together, but for what purpose?
Yeah, I wonder that too. Seems like some kind of a puzzle.
So that's where the generator key was hiding. All that was left was to use it.
Let's see if we can figure this out. There's a minus and a plus. All right, let's follow this blue wire and it goes to this wheel, to the plus. I think so, right? God, there's so many wires here. So let's put this on minus. All right, and then the plus points to the red wire, so we have to follow the red wire, which goes over here, and we have to turn this to minus. Okay, and then the plus is connected to the yellow wire, which I'm not even sure where it goes. I think it goes over here. Let's see again. What do we have? Oh, the plus. Okay. So we have to turn this to minus. Oh, it worked. Awesome. That wasn't so hard.
Open sesame. At last, so big an effort for an oh-so-tiny piece of metal.
Okay, we got the snowmobile key. But I'm not so sure what else I have to do here, or if I have to do. Let's go over there again. Maybe I have to turn that switch again. Maybe I shouldn't have turned that switch before. Let's go and check it out. Just want to make sure, because this I walked so far to get to here, and I'm gonna have to come back if I made a mistake. Alright, let's see. Oh wait, what's this?
Carl sent out an SOS.
Okay, I guess this is what I was supposed to do here, sending an SOS. I think we're done here, so I can finally head back to where I came from, if I can find my way back. I think I come here from this side. All right. I'm gonna go back to my fire and warm up, because I'm pretty sure my body is pretty frozen through the bones. There you go. I'm almost there. I'm gonna warm up again. Okay, so now I need to see how to get back, and I need to make sure I'm on the right track. It pretty much looks like I'm heading in the right direction. I'm not gonna follow those wolf tracks again. I should be able to just kind of shortcut this a little bit. And I'm really hoping not to run into more wolves. Yeah, still going the right way. Okay, should be there soon. This seems to be a faster way than through the brush, even though I see the tracks right next to me, but now they're disappearing in the brush. So I think I can go straight. Yeah, pretty much. Should be able to just go straight and get there. Yes, exactly. There we go. There's the beam and the icicle. So now I know where I am. And I think I'm gonna go back to the car at this point, because I didn't find those snowmobile tracks that I was supposed to find. I mean, I looked everywhere, so maybe they're somewhere else.
Carl hadn't lived up to his good finder reputation. He still hadn't found any of the wealth contained in Lamothe's lands.
Well, I did look everywhere, or at least I thought so. I think I'm just gonna go to my car and then come back with my car, so at least I have my car and I don't have to walk all the time. That's my plan. I think if I just continue on this road, I should get right to my car. It's a pretty long way here. I hope I make it. Almost halfway done. Okay, this is where I got some stuff. Don't have to check that again. Let's see. Yeah, still a little bit to go. Alright, almost there. I think there's like a house over here to the right. If I go a little farther, should be over here somewhere, I think. Yeah. Should be able to head up to the right here somehow, cut through and get to this. There it is. I can already see it in the distance. Okay, let's check this out. Another mysterious property. House of the Patriot. I'm sure this guy has guns. I hope he's not home. and another icicle. Alright, let's take a picture real quick and then head inside to warm up. I really hope there's nobody in the house.
The place looked more like a pigsty than a house. A heavy stench of curdled milk, cheap alcohol, and boiled cauliflower filled the air.
Boiled cauliflower, ew. All right, let's heat up a little bit here. Get body temperature back up and then see what's in here. Looks like a wallet.
It est Jean Blouin. Seems like that pig had a name after all.
All right, that's a driver's license. And some money.
Rock music invaded the minds of men even in the remotest of places. The man didn't own a turntable though, so there's that going for him. Back then, in Africa and elsewhere, people were ready to take up arms to stand against the yoke of English imperialism. In Montreal, mailboxes were blown up, abductions were carried out, and violent manifestos were distributed to media outlets. But around here, in the great northernmost, all a man could do is curse out loud against a faraway evil and pray for the revolution to arise. That man, by any reckoning, was from that very stock.
Uh-oh, a gun rack with no guns in it.
You had to be out of your mind to cook up white whiskey at home. The all-surrounding stench of alcohol alone was probably enough to gas a man to death.
Okay, so we found out where to make the caribou, but I still don't know what kind of ingredient I need. There's just a question mark. So I just have to figure it out somehow. Still can't make it though.
Carl knew right away that the owner of this place wasn't a copper collector. No, this was a junkman's base of operations. The guy definitely seemed like quite the expert in scavenging scrap metal, with or without permission, surely. In the right hands, red metal could sell like hotcakes.
Let's see what else there is in this pigsty, like he said. Food and stuff, but not really anything interesting. And I think with this, I'm gonna end this part right here, and then we can continue another time. Bye-bye.